All of us know only two states in our life, death and dying. Death and dying. Where your perception of the known ends, it is called death. Where your perception continues to torture you, it is called dying. I am introducing one of the important sacred secret about death to you. When death is staring at somebody, decide to stare at him. Understand the secret. Whenever you stare at somebody, even if he was looking at the other direction, automatically his eyes will come and get fixed on you. The good news is, if you put your attention on death, you will be liberated. The great news is, you don't have to put your attention on death your whole life. Just few days without getting diverted, put your attention, that is enough. You will have liberation. The first and foremost commandment for human beings, not just Hindus alone, for whole humanity is, thou shall not die. Thou shall not be born. If the mistake is already made, at least thou shall not die.
I was totally lame. I knew what meditation was doing it before. To come out of pains, to come out and to examine your roots, where everything is hidden, suppressed, and you know, to come out of that and just be fresh as a flower, when the dew drops on the flower, is what I have experienced here. Seriously, I mean, I cannot now explain in terms of words, but thank you, Swamiji.
After the Shivom process yesterday, I feel very light. The pain what I was undergoing, kind of some body pains, all that are relieved. I feel a kind of light. And now I have a question, who is Shiva?
I think who is Shiva, you don't need to have a question at all. Shiva is that word Shiva, that vibration Shiva. As long as it is only coming from me, I am Shiva. When it starts coming from you, you are Shiva.
I want to do completion with my bag, because every time I am searching 15 to 20 minutes, every day I am searching my bag. I am tired of losing the bag.
When we are doing the process and we are asked to do completion, I know that I will not be able to do it, and I will always think, okay, anyway, Swami will take care of it in Shiva.
Even that attitude is okay.
I'll try my best to do it, Swamiji. But when you do the Shivokam process, I know you are giving it. But then I do have a self-doubt all the times raising it. Like, oh, Swami is giving, will I be able to
take
actually, it completely?
That self-doubt will melt down if you try your best and fail.
I can't even put my Shivokam experience into words. Being in the same hall as Swamiji, for me, is completion and bliss and power and everything. But being in the same hall as Swamiji, when you can literally see that he is Mahadeva, and not only that he is Mahadeva, but that he's recreating Mahadeva in everybody around him, it's just beyond amazing. And I'd get too tongue-tied if I try to explain how I felt during the process or what was happening in me. All I can say is that my devotion has multiplied, my gratitude to be here has multiplied, everything is multiplying. And it's just too good. There are no words.
Swamiji also said in one satsang that there are lots of people who got enlightened, but they just sit in Himalayas and meditate. But the real incarnations are the ones who come down and radiate that to everyone else and raise everyone else to that level and help them experience the same thing, like Swamiji.
Being a poet, what I also feel is that for us to understand, like how Swami explained, that story of Markandeya, like when you are that shy, with like Shiva gave a boon that all his devotees will not have any of these laws of life at all. So what I feel is, when we realize that we are Shiva, that's when we are like space of Mahadeva, when we achieve that space of Shivoham, to achieve that space of Shivoham, what I feel is like we all have an opportunity of attending this 7 days. Swami has given us all a chance of attending this 7 day Shivoham process, which is going to happen from 21st to 27th in Varanasi. So what I feel is when we all attend that, and when we realize that Shiva, like we are Shiva, Shivoham, so what I feel is we'll all start having that liberated thinking.
Transformation, enlightenment, mukti need to be tasted while you are in the body. It needs to be enjoyed while you are in the body. It needs to be celebrated while you are in the body. This is the most powerful, amazing combination of inner awakening I've ever done. The usual inner awakenings where your effort is the first priority. Shivoham is where my effort is the first priority. Me gifting is the first priority. The problem is, even when I gift, you fall into self-doubt. Am I worthy of qualification? Am I ready to receive? And you use all your effort to disprove, I have not given you, you have not received it. Shivoham in Shiva home. So I welcome all of you. Come and be part of Shivoham in Shiva's home. Still it is not too late to taste Shivoham in Shiva's home. So I welcome all of you. Come and be part of Shivoham in Shiva's home. Pack your bags and book your flight and be here.